Today, straight from China, we have a cheap $40 emulation box. This is called the Arcade Box. I got this from a company called Dick Doc, straight off of AliExpress. And yeah, this thing is $40 with the free shipping. And it has over 30,000 games on it. So obviously, I was a little intrigued by this as it was one of the cheaper setups I've seen in a while anyway, as far as something you plug to your TV and have access to a bunch of games. I know some people like this kind of stuff as it's just easy, already set up for them. Some people prefer to do it themselves. And at this price point, it was like, screw it. I gotta check this thing out. So it took a couple weeks to get here from China. Not too bad of a deal. It was free shipping. But it came in a nice little case, decent case. I mean, I'm not going to say it's the nicest thing in the world. Came with the system, came with the HDMI cable, the power brick, and two controllers. Now, the controllers it came with are wired PS2-style controllers. Not the greatest in the world, to be honest, but you could pretty much use any controllers that you want on this device, wired or, like, you know, things with dongles and whatnot to get wireless action. But to just speak on the controllers that came with it, yeah, I mean, for them having this at such a low price point, they're not going to give you the greatest controllers in the world. So the little box you get, I mean, it looks pretty standard from a lot of these similar devices I've seen lately. Got like a little arcade dude with some boxing gloves on. I mean, okay, I guess the style works. It's not my favorite artwork I've ever seen in the world, but there you go, box arcade. I guess they took it a little literal, like he's an arcade machine and he's a boxer, maybe? I don't freaking know, man. But what I wanted to do was test this thing out and more focus on the heavy hitting stuff. Nintendo 64, Atomos Wave, Dreamcast, Naomi, PSP, PlayStation 1, test those things out. As we know, playing all of our, you know, retro games are 8 up to 16-bit, and even the PS1. PS1 should really be fine on this device, but all the old-school stuff, Sega Genesis, Super Nintendo, NES, you're not going to have any issues. So I didn't really want to focus too much on that stuff. This does have an Amlogic S905 chip built in. It's listed to have 8 gigs of RAM. It's 64-bit 4-core processor. The 5-core Mali 450 GPU type of thing. That's the information they have listed on the actual listing on AliExpress. But going through and playing some of these games, for the most part, I wasn't too surprised, but there were some things that I was like, oh, wow, it actually runs this. Now, we're going to have things like Atomos Wave, which is you know, arcade games. That's what I'm focusing on, is just stuff that's typically not always emulated perfectly well. And with the Atomos Wave and the Dreamcast stuff, it's a little bit of a mixed bag, but I was surprised to see Atomos Wave does perform decently well. For the most part, I did notice in games like Dolphin Blue some minor graphics issues where, like, some sprites would be missing. If you look in my clip that I show, Dolphin Blue, like, part of the character by where he's holding his weapon, it's just clear, and I'm pretty sure that's not normally how it's supposed to be, so just wanted to point that out. Games like that, on systems like that, it seems like they're mostly running fine. It's just you'll find little tiny things on occasion. Might bother you, might not. The games are still playable for the most part. Moving on to like Dreamcast, Marvel vs. Capcom 2. Surprisingly, it works fairly well, but a very similar issue as with Atomos Wave, where you might be missing some frames of animation or a minor graphics glitch, but the game runs fairly smooth. So just pointing that out. It's not perfect with those games, whereas everything else that I mentioned earlier, NES, Super Nintendo, Genesis, Sega CD, 32X, stuff like that's going to be fine. It's these things that we have to really focus in on and see if it's worth it for you. Naomi, you know, it's going to be all similar hardware, Dreamcast, Atomos Wave. Naomi with Gigawing 2. I've seen this game really struggle on some devices, but on this device, it performed really well, not having, like, sound issues, you know, stuff like that. I did notice the further you get into the game, there may be some weirdness with some of the graphics, or when you do a special move, it might kind of corrupt things, or the graphics won't show properly. But for the most part, it plays fine. Just minor graphics issues, and that's what it seems like with those three, Atomos Wave, Naomi, and Dreamcast. You'll have some games that play just fine, but you might just find those tiny little things, you know what I'm saying? So, also, playing Nintendo 64, it's another mixed bag. Like, Banjo-Kazooie seemed to play decently well. Nintendo 64's Cruisin' USA, pretty slow, bad music, Stutter and Stanley action. And then you move on to things like Cruisin' World, Cruisin' Exotica, and those games play a lot better. They're later games, but for whatever reason, they play better, and I didn't really notice too much in the way of issues here. And then you go on to things like Neo Geo CD. Obviously, Neo Geo's gonna run just fine. Neo Geo CD, I had no issues with that console at all as well. TurboGrafx CD or PC Engine CD, no issues. I mean, those are just CD-based consoles that don't really have too much of an issue being emulated on these lower-end single-board computers, so not a big deal there. Those games run perfectly fine, no issues at all. PSP, this is another one that's going to be a really mixed bag, so you have to, you know, keep your expectations in check. Playing Castlevania, which a lot of times when these kind of companies put these devices together and they just either do a ROM dump or take somebody else's build and throw it on their device type of thing, I always notice with PSP, it's usually a bunch of minis and then Castlevania will be thrown on there. Castlevania runs just fine. All the minis just run just fine. But if you wind up adding more games, PSP is going to be another one of those things where it's a case-by-case basis. Not all games are going to run perfect. Not all games are going to run, period. But Castlevania on the PSP runs just fine. No issues with that at all. PS1, to be expected. I tested a few games and I had no issues with those at all. They all perform pretty damn well. I mean, to be expected with these boards, PS1's not that difficult to get running. So no issues with PS1. Pleasantly surprised with this little $40 system. I mean, with over 30,000 games on this thing, a ton of systems, it is a little ridiculous, more than any normal person would ever need. You could always, if you did wind up buying one of these and you wanted to narrow down the game list, of course you could delete things if you wanted to, or just go through and add games to your favorites. Like I said, it's a lot of stuff here, a lot of retro consoles, really good stuff. You got ports, a little bit of everything here. It's a decent little device. You know, either you're for this kind of stuff, if you're not, I just like to review these types of items because some people wind up either bringing them up to me or I notice them and see like, oh, well, this is a pretty damn cheap within budget type of thing. Let me test it out. And this one, yeah, it's not too bad. It's one of the better ones that I've seen out there, especially at this lower price point, $40. I mean, yeah, you can go the Raspberry Pi route or any other kind of Android box route and do a similar thing. But if you wind up buying one of these, I hope this kind of gave you a good idea on what kind of performance to expect. So really do appreciate you guys watching, hanging out with me on this one. I hope this video was helpful. Catch you on next one. Bye.